Hi, my name is John Grimes, and I'm an engineer at the Australian eHealth Research Centre at CSIRO, Australia's national science agency. Today I'm going to give you an overview of SQL on FHIR, a new companion standard for FHIR designed to make it easier to use for data analytics. FHIR provides us with a standardized view of health data and a set of APIs that make it easy to send that data around and make it accessible to applications. The existence of this standard makes it easier to share data within and across organizational boundaries to provide a more complete patient record for clinical care. The adoption of FHIR by software vendors also means that we now have a larger number of cleaner, more consistent sources of data captured as part of routine data collection. Availability of FHIR data provides new opportunities to incorporate real-time clinical data into decision support, process improvement, and research. However, there are barriers to the adoption of FHIR by the typical researcher or data analyst. First of all, FHIR is not a format that is familiar for most users in the analytics space. Even if you have strong technical skills, you still need some knowledge of FHIR to be able to deal with it in its raw form. FHIR is generally distributed in either a JSON or XML format. Transformation of this data is usually required ahead of analytic tasks for performance reasons. And this leads to a proliferation of independently developed transformations from FHIR to some task-specific form. Much of this is duplicate effort and easy to get wrong. Some of these problems stem from the fact that there are just so many options for storing FHIR data. You can simply leave it as JSON or XML files and use tools that can query these files directly. You can attempt to create a normalized schema in a relational database. You can take FHIR JSON data and save it into a JSON-typed column within a database, then use JSON-specific query syntax to get it back out. Or you can use a columnar storage format such as Parquet or Orc. And this list is far from exhaustive. There are, of course, other options such as triple stores, XML databases, and proprietary services such as Google BigQuery. Experience tells us that people will use the tools that they already have, that they have experience with, and that are already integrated with the rest of their tech stack. So what hope is there for any level of standardization in this space? Are we all doomed to write the same transformations over and over again in 1,000 different dialects of query languages? Most users just want a flat table of data, including just the fields or variables that they're interested in. If you give them a JSON file that looks like the one on the left, they are probably going to tie themselves in knots trying to deal with FHIR data types, repeating elements, recursive structures, extension content, and all of the other things that you need to know to do this properly. Really, they want something more like the table on the right. If they want to transform this further, they will be happy to do so using the tools that they already have, such as SQL, R, or Python. Of course, the representation on the right contains less information than the one on the left, but perhaps it contains all the information needed for the task at hand. We have the original data and can create further views of it later as needed. The missing piece here is good tools in the middle that can automate and standardize the process. SQL on FHIR provides a way of defining standard FHIR views. These views can be use case specific, but they can also be reusable where there are overlapping data requirements between analytic tasks. A number of view runners have been developed that can execute these views using popular database and analytic tools. If you have a view definition and a view runner, you can produce easy to use views of your data using the tools you already have. Views that cover the data requirements for common use cases can be bundled with FHIR implementation guides to ease adoption and maximize reuse. Depending on the view runner and the technology used, the output can be a database table, a data frame, a CSV file, anything that can be used to represent tabular data. The idea is that view definitions exist in an architecture that has three layers: a data layer, a view layer, and an analytics layer. The data layer is some sort of representation of FHIR data. In the view layer, you put a view definition and a view runner together to transform FHIR data into views. In the analytic layer, you pick up those views and add further queries and analysis, and possibly make data available to applications, machine learning, or anything else you can imagine. View definitions are intentionally implementation agnostic and don't make many assumptions about what might be appropriate in the data layer or the analytics layer. This is the basic structure of a SQL on FHIR view definition. You can define constant values that you can refer to later in the view. You can define and name any number of columns to extract from your FHIR data. In the case of repeating elements, you have control over how these get expanded into rows. You can union multiple selections together, which can be useful for putting data from different parts of a FHIR resource into a common set of columns. And finally, you can add filter conditions, which define which FHIR resource instances will be included in the view. Each of these parts of the view definition is defined using a FHIR path expression. FHIR path is an easy way to select values out of a FHIR resource by describing a path through the data structure. The best way to show how useful FHIR path can be is to provide a few examples. The first example on this slide shows a FHIR path expression that is extracting the first names for a patient. The where function is used to filter the names to only those with a use code of official. The second example determines whether a procedure was performed after a particular date. The third example selects an immunization record based upon its code and then extracts the date of administration. Here is an example where we have a questionnaire for calculating the Glasgow Coma Scale and a view that takes responses to the questions and puts them in a simple table. First, we use the getResourceKey function to put the response ID in the first column. There are multiple questions in the questionnaire. Here we are deciding to put the response to each question on its own row. Then we will address the issue of how to represent each answer. Here we select each answer that contains a LOINC-coded response. Within each answer, we have a weight value that is stored in a FHIR extension. The extension function makes easy work of this. And then we finish off the view with two more columns containing the code and display term for each answer. This is the resulting table. We have five columns containing simple values that can be dealt with easily using generic analytic tools. There are multiple questions for each response, each on its own row. A SQL on FHIR view operates on a single resource type only. When it comes to joining views together, we decided that rather than try to replicate the join functionality of SQL and other tools, we would instead create a couple of functions that take in resources or references and return join keys. These keys make join operations trivial using the tool of your choice. Sometimes there can be complex logic involved in the creation of join keys, relating to resource versioning, contained resources, logical references, and so forth. These functions allow the view runner to apply any context-specific rules to the task of generating the keys. Here is an example of two views. One is a patient view and the other is an observation view containing blood pressure measurements. The patient view has a column containing the result of the getResourceKey function, and the observation view has a column defined with the getReferenceKey function. A simple join can bring these two tables together to form a harmonized view of both patient details and their blood pressure observations. We have also created several different profiles of the view definition that can be useful in different contexts. The base view definition has almost no constraints and is useful in scenarios where views are authored and executed on demand. Views that conform to the base profile are also free to use complex data types, which means that you can make selections that will not result in a flat table. This can be okay or even desirable when using query engines that support data types such as arrays and structures. The shareable profile imposes some requirements on the metadata that goes along with a view so that it can be identified and versioned. It is also required to declare which FHIR version it is intended to be run against, and it is required to assert the FHIR type of each column. This ensures consistent execution across a diverse set of view runners. The tabular profile adds the requirement that selections can only be made that resolve to singular, primitive values. This ensures that the result of the view can be represented as a completely flat table, and is necessary when outputting formats such as CSV that don't have any way of representing collections or complex types. You can find the full SQL on FHIR specification at this link if you want more detail on how it works, including additional examples. We already have 7 independent implementations of the SQL on FHIR view runner that we know of, and we've set up this website for those implementations to report their results against our conformance test suite. The reference implementation lives in the specification itself and is written in JavaScript. It transforms raw FHIR JSON resources into JavaScript objects or a JSON output. Aidbox is a FHIR server created by Health Samurai and has implemented a runner that transforms views into queries over its Postgres database. Pathling is an open source product by CSIRO that I'm going to talk about in detail in a moment. Google has an open source analytics pipeline as part of its Open Health Stack initiative that includes a SQL on FHIR view runner. A view runner has been implemented within the official HL7 IG publisher, capable of validating views and rendering them within its SQLite database. NCQA is using SQL on FHIR to project views of required data elements out of bulk FHIR data, in preparation for subsequent queries to calculate SQL measures. And finally, MedPlum has implemented a SQL on FHIR view runner as part of their JavaScript API. Pathling is a set of tools for FHIR analytics that we develop at CSIRO. We provide it free of charge under a permissive open source license to help move the FHIR community forward. It is built upon a technology called Apache Spark, which has a lot of advantages for scalability and streaming analytics, which we think are going to be important as the industry matures. We have recently developed a SQL on FHIR view runner within Pathling. I'm going to take you through some of the key features. Pathling can take data in bulk FHIR ndjson format, FHIR bundles, or as a stream of events over Kafka. Pathling then converts this data to a lossless data frame format, which can be optionally persisted using Parquet or Delta Lake tables. The SQL on FHIR view runner converts data from this lossless format to a view result data frame. The executed view can be persisted using any of the formats supported by Apache Spark, including relational database tables, CSV, Parquet, and other popular formats. Apache Spark has the ability to run queries over streams of data, and this enables some interesting architectures for FHIR analytics. We can leverage push APIs, such as FHIR subscriptions, to subscribe to changes and run transformations continuously over the data. In this example, we're persisting subscription events to Kafka, then streaming data from Kafka through the execution of a SQL on FHIR view using Pathling. This could be useful for applications that have real-time update requirements, such as dashboards. Pathling has comprehensive support for querying FHIR terminology built in. This functionality automates the task of making calls out to a FHIR terminology server and joining the results back alongside your data. These functions, taken together, allow you to query almost any aspect of the codes that are present within your data. This is particularly powerful when combined with terminologies such as SNOMED CT, which contain a rich set of properties and relationships. If you want to find out more about Pathling, you can check out our channel on YouTube. We have several videos introducing the tools in more detail and showing how to perform common tasks. We have a few things that we are targeting to build upon this work on SQL on FHIR view definitions. The first is to integrate the view definition with the bulk data export operation so that the result of executing a view definition could be returned, containing just the data needed. We're also working on a new specification that describes a standard way of representing FHIR in a lossless way in the Parquet format. This could be used as a more efficient alternative for bulk data interchange than the ndjson format. And finally, we would like to work on improved user interfaces for composing view definitions to enable a broader group of people to participate in the authoring of these. I would like to acknowledge some of the people and organizations that have generously contributed to this work. It has been a privilege to work with such a talented team. Thank you very much for your time and attention. I appreciate your support and would love to hear any feedback you might have. If you would like to see more content like this, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. You can also connect to me on LinkedIn to receive further updates.